Hi, welcome back to CVN 305, looking at bending. So we already did the curvature related to axial strain. We figured out the axial stress. Now we want to figure out how is the moment versus stress related. That is, moment versus curvature related. That is, we want to get this thing. Delta theta equal to ML, M delta L over EI. So we have done this. We have done this. Now we got to do work on these two. Okay. This one takes a little bit of doing because it's a bit more complicated than what you would do for a torsion problem. Where there the situation was easy. Here you have to do a little bit more on the integration side. So let's look at that. So remember that our cartoon for shear stress looked like that, right? And we figured out that sigma xx equals minus ey delta theta over delta L. Okay, so what does it mean? If I look at the cross section, here is my cross section. Here is y. Here is z. And my moment is around the z-axis, okay? And let us say this is B, this is H. This is called the height of the beam. This is called the width. So notice that at each portion of the beam, so suppose I divide it into a small area dA, somewhere here. So that's a small chunk. I want to find out how much force am I applying on that chunk. That's easy. I take the stress, multiply it with dA, and I'll find out the incremental force. If I know the force, I can calculate the moment of the force because this is y and that's z. I know where the force is applied. I know how much force is applied. I have to find the moment and then sum all the moments. Okay, let's see if we can do that. So, and we are now going to do it with vectors so that we can see all the calculations in great detail, okay? So, df, which is the vector, this is incremental force acting on a small area dA. So, how much is df? The magnitude is minus Ey delta theta over delta L times dA, right? This is the magnitude. What's the direction? This is in the I direction. I want you to realize it's coming out of the board. Can you see that? Because sigma xx, remember our notation, right? Face the force, right? So I look at the second one. I know the face is the x direction. The force is in the x direction. That's all. So that's there, okay? How much is the moment due to this force? That's easy. dm equals r cross df. You never thought you would use all this stuff from 221, did you? See, we gotta do some of these things. So what's the position vector? That's r. So r is y in the j direction plus z in the k direction. So I will get yj plus zk cross minus ey delta theta over delta l dA I. So how much is j cross I? J cross I is minus k. K cross I is j. Okay, that's how cross products work. So it's pretty easy for me to do this. Dm will be E y squared delta theta over delta L dA in the k direction plus minus E z y delta theta over delta l dA in the k cross I is j direction. So that's the moment vector for that small force. Total moment integral dm over the area, which is, notice E is constant, delta theta over delta L is constant, so we can pull that all out. E delta theta over delta L times integral y square dA over the area minus E delta theta over delta L integral y z dA. So let's do this integral. That's not too hard. No, it looks nasty, but it's not too hard. By the way, before we do this integral, this thing is called IZ. This is the moment of inertia around the z-axis. That's the definition of this. Okay? And I'm sure you have done some of this little bit in 221, ME in 221. And I'm sure you did this when you did double integrals in your math class, math 225. And again, I am sure you thought, when will I ever use mathematics? Right? You have to be patient. We know why we are teaching you this stuff. Eventually, you know what? We will need it. That's why we put it in there. Okay? So, these things are all area integrals. So, I'm going to do this first one. E delta theta over delta L times integral. So, this will become a double integral. So, I'm going to do z from minus b over 2 to b over 2. Y equal to minus h over 2 to h over 2. Why is that? It's a square rectangle, right? So it goes from minus b over 2. The total width is b. So that's minus b over 2 to plus b over 2 minus h over 2 to h over 2 of this guy. Y square dz dy minus same integral, same limits. Yz dz dy. Compute this. I mean, even if you can't come do it by hand, I know you got all these fancy calculators. Okay, so what I want you to do is pause, calculate it, and tell me what you are. Okay, if you do that, you will find that this number, E delta theta over delta L. So this number will go to zero for this rectangular cross section. And this thing will become a very simple formula, E delta theta over delta L. Times, I will get b h cubed over 12. Compute it, you will see. This is called I. So what did I get? Notice this is in the k direction. This is in the j direction. So what did I get? Moment in the k direction. Is E delta theta over delta L I, and this is what we call M, moment in the J direction equal to zero. Does that make sense to you? Look, we only applied moment in the K direction. Can you see that? There's no moment in the J direction. So obviously that's correct. So what will give me is a very nice result. Delta theta. So if I take this, I'll get delta theta equal to m delta L over EI. And I is integral y square dA. So let's recap. We have now got this result. This is the counterpart to T delta L over GJ. So notice this flea type setup works all the way across. Delta U is equal to FL over EA. Delta V equal to FL over GA. Delta theta equal to TL over GJ. Delta theta equal to, delta phi equal to TL over GJ. Delta theta equal to ML over EI. how much easier can you get? There's nothing to it. Okay. So there's only one last thing left, and that's an easy thing to show, which is sigma was E minus EY delta theta over delta L, right? So I can take for delta theta, substitute it here, and you will get the E will cancel out, and I'll get minus MY over I. In many books, this will be written as MC over I. I want you to realize that this is in many books. They will write it like this. But I want you to realize that this is the formula. Minus MY over I. Because I want you to get the signs correctly. Okay. So be careful. So I want you to memorize it like this. And you will see that that's the counterpart to this guy. See? TR over J minus MY over I. F over A. F over A. Can you see how beautifully all those things work? There's nothing to it. You just have to be systematic. With that, we are done for this lesson.